Do you ever wonder how scientists figure out how to predict the effects of climate change? Well, you're not alone. We received this question from Vaidik in Gatineau.
How do we create computer models to forecast the changing in London?
Good question. Research scientist Diogo Costa knows a thing or two about these computer models, otherwise known as mathematical models. Diogo, could you enlighten us?
The first thing to understand is what mathematical models actually are. A mathematical model can be a simple equation or a combination of many equations. Now, our planet is a fascinating place. It can be also a very complicated system where the weather interacts with a geological cycle, which in turn interacts with the biogeochemical and ecological processes. So, computer models of the environment tend to be quite complicated and involve many equations, particularly a set of equations that we call partial differential equations. In a sense, these mathematical equations relate properties of objects, forces, and states. For example, Newton's second law of motion relates mass and acceleration of an object with the amount of force of pull or push that is needed to accelerate it. So, as you can imagine, this can be very powerful. In a sense, models for environmental diagnosis or forecast are very similar to this example. They relate properties and forces in the environment. However, there are many processes that need to be represented in these models. Imagine you want to develop the model to predict flooding. Well, you need to have multiple equations to predict each of the processes involved in the hydrological cycle, which includes evaporation, evapotranspiration, precipitation, snow accumulation, blowing snow, snow melt, infiltration, stream flow, hydrodynamics in streamers and lakes, groundwater flow, and on and on and on. And the truth is that many hydrologists dedicate entire careers to study one or a few of these processes. Try to find the most accurate way to represent the processes in these bigger mathematical models of the hydrological cycle. Catchment hydrological models apply all of these equations, each one representing one important process. So they try to mimic the hydrological cycle in a virtual way.
Wow, mathematical models are definitely complex, but it's amazing what useful and important information they can tell us. Keep sending us your questions so we can keep learning from the experts here at Ask a Scientist.